Welcome to an example on how to solve a rational equation. The method discussed in this video can be considered an alternative method because it is slightly different from the method shown in most textbooks. But I think it can be helpful because normally when we see the addition and subtraction of fractions, the first thing we think of is obtaining a common denominator. So to solve our rational equation, we're going to build fractions that have the same least common denominator. Then we're going to multiply each fraction by the common denominator to clear the fractions from the equation, solve, and then check our solution or solutions. So looking at our example, in order to obtain our common denominator, the first step is to factor all the denominators. Well, looking at the fractions on the left, the quantity x minus 6 and the quantity x minus 2 don't factor, but on the right, the quantity x squared minus 8x plus 12 will. So for the first fraction, we'll just have 1 over the quantity x minus 6 plus x divided by the quantity x minus 2. And now on the right side, we'll have 4 divided by this trinomial, which we'll now factor. So the factors of x squared are x and x. And the factors of 12 that add to negative 8 are negative 6 and negative 2. And now before we obtain our common denominator, let's talk about the values of x that we must exclude. We know division by 0 is undefined, so notice how if x is equal to 6 or x is equal to positive 2, we would have division by 0, so we must exclude those two values from possible solutions. So let's just say x can't equal 6 and x can't equal positive 2. We should also recognize now our least common denominator is going to be the quantity x minus 6 times the quantity x minus 2. So for our first fraction here on the left, notice how the denominator is missing a factor of x minus 2. So we'll multiply both the numerator and denominator by the quantity x minus 2. Now this first fraction does contain our least common denominator. And for the second fraction, notice how the denominator is missing a factor of x minus 6. So we're going to multiply both the numerator and denominator by the quantity x minus 6. Now that all the fractions contain the same least common denominator, we can multiply both sides of the equation by this common denominator to clear the fractions. So if we multiply the left side of the equation by the quantity x minus 6 times the quantity x minus 2, if we want, we can put this over 1, and then multiply the right side by the same quantity x minus 6 times the quantity x minus 2. Notice for each product, we're going to have a factor of x minus 6 over x minus 6 and a factor of x minus 2 over x minus 2, which will clear all the fractions from the equation. So for this first product, we would just have 1 times the quantity x minus 2. For the second product, we would just have x times the quantity x minus 6. And on the right side, we would just have 4. And now we're going to solve this equation to find our solution. So we'll clear the parentheses and solve for x. So if we distribute 1, we'll just have the quantity x minus 2 plus distributing x, we'd have x squared minus 6x equals 4. We notice how we have a quadratic equation. Looking at the left side of the equation, here's we have x or 1x minus 6x. So we have x squared minus 5x minus 2 equals 4. Now we'll set this equal to 0 and factor. So we'll subtract 4 on both sides. Well, if we subtract 4 on both sides, we'd have x squared minus 5x minus 6 equals 0. And this is going to factor. We have x and x. The factors of negative 6 that add to negative 5 are negative 6 and positive 1. So this product is equal to 0 when x minus 6 equals 0 or x plus 1 equals 0, which means our solutions are x equals 6 or x equals negative 1. However, remember we said from the very beginning we had to exclude 6 as a solution. But because this appears as a solution, but it can't be a solution, This is called an extraneous solution, which means it's not a solution, even though it appears to be, and our only solution is x equals negative 1. So when solving a rational equation, and the guidelines tell us to check our solutions, this is really the most important thing to check for. We need to make sure that our solutions are not one of the excluded values, or a value that would produce division by 0. So our solution is x equals negative 1, which would check as a solution. I hope you found this helpful.